Hi guys, welcome to a brand new series all about hermit crab care. I'm hoping to upload these videos every other week, and each week it will have a different aspect of hermit crab care. I would like these videos to be very thorough, so each video will have one topic. For example, temperature, humidity, or shells. In this video, I'm going to be talking about all the good and bad types of hermit crab substrates. I will be going over the pros and cons of each type, and in the end, I'll let you know what I actually use in my hermit crab tank. The first one I'm going to talk about is coconut fiber. Now, coconut fiber is just that. It is dried, compressed coconut. There are a couple different brands of it. The one I use is called EcoEarth. Depending on the species of animal you have, it can be used either dry or moist, but for hermit crabs, it's always used moist. They cost about $9 for a 3-pack like this one, and all you do is you take one of the bricks and you add water, and this is what happens. So EcoEarth is definitely safe for hermit crabs, and I actually use it in my own crabitat. Now let's go over the pros and cons of it. So the first pro is that it is safe for crabs. Obviously, this is the most important part of a substrate. Secondly, it holds humidity really well. So if you're struggling to keep the humidity high enough in your tank, EcoEarth can really help you. And lastly, it looks very natural. Now the cons of EcoEarth are, because it gets so humid in the tank, things tend to get moldy easier if your hermit crabs leave food laying on the EcoEarth or some of your decorations. It just seems to get moldy easier. And secondly, it can be messy. Because we use the coconut fiber moist, it tends to stick to the crabs and stick to everything in the tank, so when you're cleaning it, it can be a little bit bothersome. The next substrate we're going to talk about is play sand. Play sand is another one that I use in my crabitat, and I like it for many reasons, but the main one is it's easy to find and you can buy a lot of it for fairly cheap. I get my play sand at a local home improvement store, although it's available at a lot of different places. The main thing to look for when you're trying to find play sand is that it is clean, natural, and washed. You want to look for ones that are marketed towards children's sandboxes and other similar things, just because those ones tend to be cleaner and not have any harmful chemicals or dyes in them. So play sand is safe for your crabs, but it also has a lot of other pros. Play sand is definitely the cheapest substrate you can buy for your hermit crabs. You can get a 50-pound bag for only $3 or $4. It will make your crabitat look very natural and beachy. The only con that I can give play sand is that it lacks humidity. Even if you initially wet it, it will eventually dry out and it can be hard to maintain sandcastle consistency. So those were our good substrates, and now we are on to the bad ones. To start off with here, we have gravel, which is unfortunately one of the most common types of substrate used for hermit crabs. So gravel has literally no pros to it. It is a horrible, horrible substrate to use for your crabs, and here is why. Gravel is considered an unsafe substrate for many different reasons. The main one is that it prevents your hermit crabs from molting, which is super, super important. Hermit crabs dig down into their substrate to molt so that they are protected from the other crabs. Even if there's only one crab in the tank, their instincts tell them that it's not safe to molt on the surface and they need to dig down. So if hermit crabs are kept on gravel, which is a substrate they can't dig down into, they can actually put off molting, and if they do that for long enough, they'll die. Another con that gravel has is because it's an unnatural substrate that hermit crabs wouldn't be walking on in the wild, it can actually break the tips of their legs off and their claws. And this, of course, puts the crabs under a lot of stress. This next substrate fits into more of a category than a specific kind, and for this example, I'm using mulch in my yard, but what I'm really talking about is any type of wood chips, mulch, shavings, or forest bedding that you see commonly sold in pet stores. The only pro I can give this type of bedding is that it looks natural. I say this with a question mark because I actually think that EcoEarth and sand look much more natural. And like gravel, this type of substrate has a long list of cons. It is another substrate that I would consider unsafe because it, again, prevents the hermit crabs from digging down to molt. And also, a lot of different types of wood can be toxic for hermit crabs, and you don't always know when buying these beddings what type of wood they are made of. The last substrate I want to talk about today goes by two names. It is called hermit crab sand, as well as calci sand. The biggest pro that calcium sand has is that it provides the crabs with calcium, which is a necessary part of their diet. The truth is that calcium sand has a lot of cons to it, and there are other ways to provide your crabs with calcium. The biggest con that calcium sand has is that it is extremely expensive. For $6, I could get either this 2-pound bag of hermit crab sand, or I could get about 100 pounds of natural play sand. Besides being expensive, hermit crab sand is also unsafe for hermit crabs. The main reason being that when it gets wet, it actually sticks and hardens. And two big problems that can happen with this type of substrate is that your hermit crabs will get wet, and then they roll around in the substrate and they get stuck inside their shells. And two, when they go down to molt and their substrate is wet, it will actually harden around them and cause them to get trapped underground. After watching this video, I hope you guys agree that the best substrates to use for hermit crabs are EcoEarth and play sand. And I actually use both of these substrates in my crab habitat. Because sand is cheaper than EcoEarth, and EcoEarth is more humid than sand, I prefer to mix the two together and create the perfect hermit crab substrate. So that's it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it and learned something from it. Like I said at the beginning of this video, this is going to be a new series on hermit crab care. The next video in this series will be talking more about substrate, and it will talk about things like depth and sandcastle consistency, more of the fine-tuned details now that you guys know the proper substrate. In the description of this video, I'll be putting a list of all the videos I hope to make to go in this series, so make sure you check that out. Anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, leave it a like, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!